Fetal circulation is a remarkable process that ensures the proper growth and development of a fetus in the womb. By utilizing a series of shunts, blood flow is redirected and optimized to meet the demands of vital organs such as the heart, brain, and lungs. This includes the ductus venosus, ductus arteriosus, and foramen ovale, which is what we are going to discuss in this quick video. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. The process of fetal circulation is different than that of an adult because the fetus is not yet capable of breathing air and obtaining oxygen through the lungs. Instead, oxygen and nutrients are supplied to the fetus by the placenta via the umbilical cord. Oxygenated blood from the placenta enters the fetal body through the umbilical vein and flows into the hepatic circulatory system. Approximately one-third of this blood goes to the lower trunk and extremities, while the other two-thirds flow through the ductus venosus and directly into the inferior vena cava. This blood in the inferior vena cava is well oxygenated, but it mixes with venous blood returning from the lower extremities, entering the right atrium. Around 50% of this mixed blood is shunting from the right atrium into the left atrium through the foramen ovale, which is a small opening in the intraatrial septum. The left atrial blood then flows into the left ventricle and eventually into the ascending aorta, supplying the brain, brachiocephalic trunk, and descending aorta. Venous blood from the superior vena cava is directed downward into the right atrium, then into the right ventricle, and finally into the main pulmonary artery. However, the relatively low PaO2 and the presence of prostaglandins in the fetal blood result in pulmonary vasoconstriction and increased pulmonary vascular resistance. This leads to a higher pulmonary artery pressure than aortic blood pressure, which causes approximately 90% of the blood entering the pulmonary artery to shunt through the ductus arteriosus, which is a muscular vessel connecting the trunk of the pulmonary artery to the aorta, into the systemic circulation. Only the remaining 10% of blood actually flows into the lungs. The mixed blood flowing through the ductus arteriosus is routed into systemic circulation, supplying some of it to the gut, lower extremities, and placenta. The exchange of gases and nutrients between the fetus and the mother takes place through the two umbilical arteries, which carry blood from the fetal abdominal aorta to the placenta. And that is the simplified process of fetal circulation. Again, fetal circulation is a crucial aspect of development and survival, providing the fetus with the oxygen and nutrients necessary for growth and development until it can breathe air and take in oxygen through the lungs. If there's only one takeaway to remember, it's this. Remember that during fetal circulation, 90% of blood bypasses the pulmonary circulation through the foramen ovale and ductus arteriosus via right to left shunting. Shunting that continues after birth is considered to be abnormal and may require medical intervention. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.